Hello everyone, in this lesson we learned how to set up a Spring JDBC project in a most simpler manner. Okay, so let's start from scratch by creating a project. So we are using Spring toolsuit and we will be creating a project like this. Right click new Spring starter project, and what are the things we need to take care here? Now I will select here. So I will call my project what? Hello Spring JDBC. Spring, this is my project name. We are using Maven for our build management or library management. And this is my group name. This is artifact. Now let's go next. Here, whenever we are using what? Working with JDBC part, what I will select here? JDBC, I will type. It will give us some set of options. There are JDBC API, that means this is the native JDBC API, and this is Spring Data JDBC. So if you are keep on using Spring JDBC API, so this will give us as a suggestion also frequently used. So that has been added now, and apart from this, after this, now we will inform which database you want to use. MySQL driver. So it will add the MySQL driver also as a part of our dependency. So now what? We do not have to go to the Maven repository and copy the dependency and update our form.xml. Okay, so right now we will be concentrating only on the Spring JDBC and MySQL. So we are not adding any further dependencies. So go next and finish. So this will take again some time if you are creating your project first time. So if your project creation becomes successful, what we will see, let's start with the form.xml. And if you look carefully, what you will find that all the dependency MySQL connector Java, that this has also been added in our dependency. And apart from this, data JDBC, Spring Boot Starter plus data JDBC, that means Spring JDBC also has been added. All the required dependency has been added in our project. Okay, now let's start with our SRC, and this is our first program. This is our main program. Here we will write what? Here we will execute our program. Okay, this is the place we will start, and this is the place where the Spring Boot loads the Spring configuration. Okay, and let's write at least hello world one more time. What for the hello world writing, what we do? Implements command line runner, and with the help of Eclipse only, what we generate? The unimplemented method. And I write what? Hello world. So why we are creating a separate method here? Because we don't want to clutter anything in our main method. So our main method is only we are using just to load the Spring framework into the project. Now if you go and try to run our project now. Can I run the program? Right click, run as Java application. So if you run the project first time using Spring JDBC, now look out the output carefully. What does it say? Fail to configure data source. That means Spring is asking and helping us to understand that you want to use Spring JDBC in your project, but you have not tell me, you have not informed me what is your database, where is your database, what is your URL, what is your password. You have not informed me. That's why it got failed. So fail to determine the suitable driver class also. Okay, that means what? Somehow we have to inform to the Spring framework that these are my JDBC related information or data source information. For this, now where I will go? I will go to the resources. Since this is a configuration related information, where do we put? Under the resources, under the application properties file. And here now I will start typing something. Data source. So now here, what are the things we will configure? URL, username, password, and driver. So what is my URL? You now, I hope by this time you are remember now, JDBC, MySQL, and the address of your database. We will make sure our database is up and running. We will copy this URL. In your case, it could be localhost and then test. This is my database name. Port number is, but if you do not specify port number, what will happen? It will look out for 3306. Okay, so this is our URL. Then we'll write what? Data source dot username. What is my username? In my case, the username is MySQL. Data source dot password. You can see that the Spring toolsuit is helping us to create the configuration file also. Okay, configuration related information. Now the fourth thing is required was driver. So again I will type what? Data source. Why we are putting everything under the data source? Because it is related with your JDBC. Data source dot driver class name. So now what is our class name? Com dot. Now you can see that Spring Event helping us, you suggesting you the driver name. So I will select this CJ. So how many things we have required? Four things. These four things are minimum things required. So now let's go back and run the project one more time. Right click, run as Java application. Now you can see we are getting the output hello world. That means our Spring JDBC, in this way what we have done, we have successfully configured, set up the Spring JDBC project. Okay, in the next session we will learn how to perform JDBC operation with the help of Spring JDBC.